Hey guys, it's Self-Mind7 here, and I'm back with another video. Now today I'm going to be showing you guys a new Fortnite gauntlet. And my god, dude, this thing is OP if you know how to play correctly. So this is me just dropping in as Thanos. You know, I just barely just got it, just trying it out to see what to do. And so you could basically, you could just add a bunch of different moves into you. So like you could pulse down to the ground, like do a ground pound if you press X and then press the punching, which is R2. One thing you could do is that you could destroy buildings with the stones, which is pretty obvious, but one thing I was caught off guard is that you don't have all the stones, but Thanos does have all the stones in the movies, and even in the gameplay you can see him with all the stones. But you only get an ability of 3 moves, which is ground, jumping, punching, and just using laser. And I completely understand why they want to add all of the stones, because you could, some of them don't really make sense in Fortnite, but some, I mean, if you have all stones you could just completely become invincible at certain points. Like the reality stone could just, you be like super building, which, you know, just wouldn't really make sense at all. But yeah, this is the new gameplay with the gauntlet. And yeah, you see you could jump, and then you can also use your laser just to do like an aerial attack. Now when you're using the attacking punching, you literally have no limits to it. Sometimes you could one shot players, two shot players, but whatever is in front of you, you destroy it. Even in jumping, no matter what's in front of you, you destroy it. The only thing that has limits is the laser, which takes some time to destroy some buildables. It's like the LMG. It's not great at destroying buildables, but it's also, you know, one of the best things to do, because you could just completely destroy a base that's already made. But also the punching is like one of the best, in my opinion, the ability to use. You see, like, it takes some time to destroy it, but it destroys it pretty quickly. As you can see here, that when I kill this player, you can see that I go from 150 shield to 300 shield. And you, so it looks like every time you kill a person, you're able to regenerate some of your shield. And, you know, I'm not going to say it's kind of OP, but at the same time, it's pretty easy to kill Thanos. I think one of the best guns is either to use a SCAR, rocket launcher, or the LMG, because that's how I killed Thanos, by just using an LMG when he was low health. But honestly, this dude's like OP. Like, even from a high attack, he's so ground pounds, and look at it, it's like totally OP. And also, I kind of wanted to have the homing launcher. Just imagine that, just imagine 4 homing missiles just going in on Thanos, and just Thanos just like grabs the gauntlet and just flies away, or just like grabs him and throws him back. Like, think that would have been awesome if they bring back the homing launcher. You see, like, you could right now, like, I'm using the aerial and I'm at 274 health, and I'm like, oh no, I'm about to die. But one thing is that as soon as I kill them, I get 300 back in my shield, but I don't think I get none of my health back. I might be wrong about that, because I just got the gameplay and I'm doing this commentary. So yeah, it looks like you don't get back your health and only your shield, which is makes pretty much sense, because if somebody just grabs Thanos, then automatically you just win the game, because you're able to get back all your health and all your shield. So I think Thanos might be OP for now, but as soon as people start clapping up and not, you know, shooting each other, Thanos is going to be pretty easy to take down. As soon as people learn that they don't kill each other and kill Thanos first, then that's when Thanos becomes like very weak against other players. So yeah guys, this is the end of the video, and in my opinion I feel like Thanos for the beginning of the event might be OP, but as soon as people start to learn that they need to kill Thanos first and not each other, then that's when Thanos will ultimately become, you know, a liability. But for now he's OP. So yeah guys, it was Self-Line780 here. Peace.